And you have people that are sheltering in place, and after work they might have a couple drinks at night. Now it's at 3 o'clock. Now it's at 1 o'clock. Now they're starting to drink at 10 in the morning. And once this whole COVID thing is lifted, we're going to have a lot more people not only struggling with alcoholism, but mental health issues. My name is Tim Ryan. I am a person in long-term recovery, and I am here within the know. We're going to talk about people that are in recovery, how to keep them sober, and also look for signs that if someone might be drinking too much or utilizing drugs in this pandemic, we have solutions. So what we have going on now is a pandemic within a pandemic. We've had a substance abuse, alcoholism, mental health pandemic going on. Now with COVID-19, people are living in fear. There's a lot more anxiety. Alcohol sales are up over 250%. Phone calls to the mental health helplines are up over 800%. But what a lot of people are doing is starting to mask the symptoms with alcohol and drug abuse. What people need is purpose and connection. Even if they're not in recovery, take the individual that's 6 months sober or a year sober. That's a huge accomplishment. You can't go to your meetings. You can't get a 6 month coin or a year long coin. Everything shut down. You have to readjust. So it's having a routine. Don't be sleeping in till 10, 11 o'clock because you have nothing to do. Still get up early, eat a healthy breakfast, pray and meditate, work out. Even if it's 10 push-ups and 10 sit-ups a day, you need to keep your mind active. Take a walk around the block, turn off a lot of the negativity because it can be that one catalyst that says, you know what, I'm gonna have a drink and you're off to the races again. And this is the only disease that will tell you you're cured, and it will tell you, you know what, maybe you can have a drink. And then Pandora's box is open. If you're in a dark place, I'm thinking of using or whatever, first thought, second thought, third thought is okay, but you need to tell on yourself. Pick up your phone, use FaceTime, reach out to people, because ultimately you're only as sick as your secrets. Family members or friends are seeing something, or you're FaceTiming and talking with the friend and they're slurring their words a little bit and it's noon, chances are there's an issue. If you know something's up, chances are something's up. One of my mottos is if you baby an addict, you're gonna bury them. Nobody wants to talk about the elephant in the room. Well, that elephant in the room has no reason to change. They've got a roof over their head, clothes on the back, food on the table. There's really no accountability. So if I was in that situation, I'm gonna keep doing what I do until I'm confronted. And what people need to do is talk to people through love and grace. Hey, John, I think you're drinking a little too much here, but you have to open the conversations. And a lot of times people need to seek an interventionist or a proper counselor or a therapist to really help guide and direct you through that process. Rehab.com has over 35,000 licensed treatment providers. You can fill out a 30-second questionnaire whether you have no insurance, Medicaid, Medicare, in-network, out-of-network. It will give you at least 3 resources within 30 seconds. We've actually done interventions virtually, substance abuse treatment virtually. And when the time's right, if they need to get into treatment, well, then we can figure out what we need to do that. But it's out there, it's available. People just need to look for the resources. You know, this is temporary, and unfortunately, when people are in the grips of alcoholism or addiction, they don't think there's a way out. All you've got to do is stop digging. Stop digging the hole, drop the shovel. If you have a heartbeat, you have hope, all you got to do is put your hand up and ask for help. And there are thousands of people that will be there to guide and direct you, to help guide you on the road to recovery.